good afternoon, good morning to the audience, and it's nice to have this opportunity to be a part of this RDA Adoption Week and these events. And I will talk a little bit about the technical implementation and development of the CCI Data Center, the role of RDA, and also its knowledge transfer. Of course, also our plans and next steps for the evolution on the implemented dynamic data citation service here in Austria. So with the title, Scalable Dynamic Data Citation Methodology, so I will do not go so much deep into the technical implementation, so more a little bit talk about this, our experience, what we made. But nevertheless, if you want to have a technical question and also discussion, so I'm available. CCA, Marike mentioned it, is an abbreviation or stands for Climate Change Center Austria. The CCA is a non-profit association for Austrian research institutions and universities, which deals within the scientific domain of climate change. One department of CCA is the data center, as part of the Austrian research data infrastructure, and it was established in 2015. And we promote with our services the interoperability in the technical sense regarding fair data principles, but also other standards like ISO OGC. And with our service offer, we want to support the collaboration between different science and scientific and research communities. We feel in the end our services and our background is to feel responsible for better data access and reuse of reproducible results and data preservation, processing and analysis, as well as to provide support to maintain data management, the data lifecycle, and also to set up some modules and software developments to keep and get this data provenance as concept. We focus with our server infrastructure on NetCDF. NetCDF is a quite common data format environment for this climatological domain. Data are visualized by our web services we provide, but as user you are also able to get information direct on the point, not only on this large spatial scale. And our scope is not only Austria, we have also some global and atmospheric data here, but really to the range on the local scale and high resolution scale. So these climate models mostly are products from scientific collaboration. So, but in this. This collaboration has also some consequences. It means we have a lot of dependencies between the different level of data products and also calculated and modeled results. Just an example here as a kind of picture how it works and how this climate domain is used to work and process data results. The question is operator, like me, is how to keep all this information about this process chain, about the lineage, and in the end, what we really named in a scientific way is the data provenance. How to keep information for a clear data provenance. Here I want to have a short list. So on this adoption line, what we did. I moved to Vienna in 2015 to set up or to be responsible for this data center here. And also at this time I came to contact with Andreas Rauber. He's also from Vienna, and to discuss a little bit about proper data management and also his experience about the identifier management. At the same time, the RDA working group on data citation almost finished this recommendation on the data citation of evolving data and data fragments. So that's why also the name dynamic. And from the beginning, I was quite convinced about this concept and this recommendation here. You can see it also in the figure, this 14 recommendation on how to keep this data citation in a proper implementation. And we published this this concept in a design and implementation study, also as RDA. Pilot at this time, and in summer 2017 we celebrated the first release of this dynamic data citation service within an RDA webinar, and also in the following time came into this RDA adoption program. So here's one rough sketch about our problem or issue, what we want to solve. To align a persistent identifier to data and combine this with meta information. Also, with versioning is one task, but not as simple than it looks like. And also working with large files like these show data cubes here is often not so efficient. Normally, the user creates a kind of subset and data fragment and save this on his own desk or own infrastructure environment. If you want to share this data fragment, so in most cases it happens really physically. The alternative is, of course, if you want to share this, to share also these arguments from which this fragment have been created, like this, like a bounding box, or this spatial extension, and perhaps also a time frame, and so on. Thinking this option a little bit further, if you want to share this fragment, you can also republish this data fragment in a data portal. But how to ensure that you describe exactly the correct meta information of these data fragments, like credits, authorship, and so on, and also these versions. There's a kind of uncertainty, of course, if you have to do it manually. And in this use case, there is no consideration made if the origin data was corrected or get a new version. So what will happen with this fragments here, like the blue cube I showed here. And also these arguments or this text comes directly from RDA, from the RDA working group, and it shows and it describes really at the point that research data is dynamic and we have to identify precisely the data at the specific point of time, and also want to describe precisely this process of subsetting. And also in this picture here, you can see how it works, the graphical user interface. In the end, you have to choose a climatological parameter, like temperature or something else. Choose the area of interest, and also you have a possibility to choose a time range. And the second step of this is that the data are this subset is we published, and the smart thing and the smart idea which comes from RDA from this working group is really that we working only on arguments and the which is saved or stored in a query store, and the queries with the queries you can execute the subsetting process again to get exactly this data fragment what you want to provide and what you want to share. And for us, using this subset service, for us it's just a matter of implementation to keep all and all information and meta information from the origin data set and keep all these relation versions and so on. Yeah, for detailed description, we also got this opportunity to make some publication on it on this service. So just a few, and here are also some pictures about this what we described within RDA, and we were supported from the RDA Europe group to promote these results and also this service in different stories and also this adoption story cards. So and our future plan is really that we want to extend our service also to other to further scientific domain. Here's one example. It's just a case or a use case draft with the Earth Observation Data Center. This is also an Austrian institution which deals with this European Sentinel data as a data archive, and we are thinking how to how to set up our ideas on data citation directly to other data sources. And the reason was really in the end, Austria is it's quite little, and also our community is not so big. We were looking really to extend our user community, and also with this smart concept to establish this service without redundant storage and redundant data collection. So we are really thinking to create an quite broad software tool regarding this OpenEO scripts and also standardized queries and catalog services. To extend also this idea for a broader community. Yeah, and one thing, it's also for us quite fancy is and I put it here a little bit so, or described it here, is also this, from my perspective, the high potential of this open data cube initiative. So, yeah, it was a short view and a short introduction on our work. If you have any question and further question, please, I'm here and available. Thank you.